29 of the dustmen in North Westminster will lose their jobs if they go along with the council's productivity deal, but the remaining 170 will get another £15 a week. According to the council, the deal will also save the ratepayers £150,000 a year. These men do the rounds in Paddington, St John's Wood and Marylebone. Their colleagues in the south of the borough have already accepted a similar scheme which saved £750,000. But these men point out that that deal involved far fewer redundancies. That argument doesn't impress the council.
Why are they different from those in the south? The south, they're the same kind of people, and they've accepted the deal, and they accepted it readily, quickly, and it's working very well.
They say that the men accepted a previous deal last May, which meant a loss of 36 men, and now feel they've done their bit. But the council say that some of the crews are still working as little as 22 and a half hours a week.
Misleading that. I put a figure nearer 30, but you must also realise that a lot of crews go out before starting time. There's lots of area work, basement work within the Westminster area, and so therefore you find that the men go out and get the work up to ground level before they actually clock on.
The productivity deal also means that the men will have to be on duty throughout their shift and won't be able to go home as soon as they finish their work as they can now. But the men say their main worry is that the council will eventually want to bring in private contractors to replace them.
They're whittling away at the flip, so that when it comes to time for the private contractors to put their tenders in, they will then put in at a lower level because there's a lower fleet to work.
And so what does that mean?
It means it'll be easier for contractors to come in the future. And the men feel that even if we go on this new productivity deal now, it'll only be a matter of time before private contractors come in.
Councillor Porter says it's not intended to replace the men with private workers, and in any case, it's all been discussed before.
There have been about 25 meetings spread over a year. The director of cleansing has been and seen them all. He's talked to them in groups of 12. He's been through absolutely everything. And all that I can say to this is that we've come to the end of the line. We're interested in giving the service, the best possible service, for the least amount of money.
Tonight, the councillors decide whether or not to present the rebel dustman with an ultimatum, accept the deal or face the sack. At the moment, it looks as though the men may have to eventually accept the deal, but it won't be without a fight. Michael Wilson, Thames News.